During my undergrad at Penn State University, I did a bachelor's in electrical engineering, mathematics, and physics. And I was trying to go for a PhD after that point, but when I graduated, it was during the recession. There weren't so many jobs available at the time. I started working for Westinghouse Electric Company, and then I had an opportunity to explore Purdue's online master's program. When this program came up and they accepted me, I was like so taken aback, and I felt like I've got a second chance to do this. A lot of my classes had both online students and in-person students, so the professors had to find a way to accommodate everybody with the online videos. The nicest part about having the video is you can go back and forth if you need to. They said something, you're like, whoa, I didn't understand that. You can rewind, okay, now I get it. It's super helpful having that ability, maybe even better than being there in person. One of the nice things about the degree that I really liked is the flexibility, especially a couple times when I was traveling. The plan had a huge problem during the weekend, and we had a midterm exam coming up, and I emailed him and said, like, Professor Girl, please, is there any way I can get some extra time? And he was so completely like accommodating for me. So things like that made a program, I mean, they understand that you're a working professional and they're willing to work with you. So that was a really great experience. The professors that are doing these programs, they're really engaged. I took a power electronics class and I really struggled with it. It was so freaking hard. And that guy met with me every single week. We had Skype sessions for, I'd say, about an hour at a time. And he sat with me, we worked through homeworks, we went over questions I had on quizzes and exams, and he helped me get through that class. And by the end, he said, like, you should definitely consider doing a PhD even at Purdue. Fast forward to today, and now I'm here, really, really here. So it has been like a dream come true. He ended up extending a research opportunity for me for the DC Nanogrid house. And that's what I'm doing now. So my background is in electrical engineering, but my PhD is formally in mechanical. The DC Nanogrid house is, I would say, probably half and half. It's half mechanical and half electrical, which is great, because that was my original intention anyways, trying to round myself out. I was so blown away that like an institution like Purdue, which is so highly decorated and ranked within the US, would want somebody like me going there. I mean, I was just blown away. It is probably one of the most rewarding things I've ever done. Anybody can do this if you're willing to dedicate the time and the effort to it. As long as you're willing to do that, you will succeed. And I mean, the great thing about a degree is it can never be taken from you. You get to have that for the rest of your life.